Well, as you can hear the background, sounds of the shots being fired, we've got another All-Stars match lined up for you. And this time it's it's a real All-Stars match. It's the best of the best of the top divisions against each other in both Capture the Flag and Team Survivor. My co-shoutcaster this evening is Riches, or Riches, or however you want to pronounce it. How do you want to pronounce it?
With Riches.
Riches. Okay. I'll say Riches then. I would just like to do a quick shout out to Tug. Congratulations. It's his 18th birthday. God, I feel old. Anyway, we've got a great selection of players here this evening. I can see at least three ace players. All tapped up. Anyway, I think that Riches has the maps for us.
Yes, they'll play Turnpike at the first map, and after that, I think they will play the map Casa.
Casa, yeah. So Turnpike for CTF and Casa in Team Survivor. By the way, this is Riches' first Shoutcast ever, so thanks a lot for joining us. I'm sure you'll do fine. apparently everybody has started using other tags now.
Yeah, except Destroy. Yeah. No, we're Spain, man. He's actually the only Spain people in this big and All-Star match.
Okay. Interesting, definitely. Carhum and Sutafu talking Dutch to each other just a couple of minutes ago. They were both talking about that they're both TS players and definitely not CTF players and shouldn't be playing at the moment. But hey, it's the best of the best in both game types. I'm sure nobody would mind having Carhum or Sutafu in his or her CTF team. Carhum was also mentioning that his headset was broken. Always a good start for a match. And at the moment, we're just waiting for the red team to ready up, and there we go.
Have fun, guys, at watching.
Yeah, and tonight's GTV cameraman is Blacksoul, so also a first time, I think, for him. Anyway, we're going to follow Taker here at the beginning.
Yeah, it was really nice teammate. Ah, he's probably low in death. He got long.
Got taken out full. Two kills there by Sutafu in a row that were both defenders of the blue side. And Goddess here.
And no Goddess push, some maybe for a double cap.
Backup at least, yeah.
No. It will be good, yeah.
But still, great cap by Sutafu there. 30 seconds, already a cap. And we'll go and see a counter cap here, unless Julia manages to fuck up, which I doubt she will. At least I hope that it is a she.
Oh, yeah.
Jeez, Sutafu is so... What an awesome player, seriously.
Yes, he's lucky. And go up.
Here going for the push, deciding to.
Yeah, it's 5-4, so maybe you should push him a little bit.
Against two at the moment, and yeah, that's a great attacking combination there from blue. This should be a cap. Assumption will probably drop the flag, or no, wait for a little bit of stamina and do the slide. Making it 2-1.
Nice.
That's a cap every 30 seconds. I'm enjoying it already. All-Stars TS versus All-Stars CTF is making a difference, since the TS players are now
one low in that, so actually I recognize that Calm is the only one who wanted the CTF small and not big, so we can see even the best player are only people
who
make
Even if you only have a couple of pixels left for that, you know that it's Karham. Anyway, let's have a look if we can find Julia. Oh, Julia went through middle, and Destroy is going to be too late to intercept.
Oh, we can free go to the pushing.
Great movement there by Goddess, but going to be taken out full here. Yeah, got taken out full by Aiden. Good job.
But he'll have no in death, and I think that will be a contact attack.
Mm-hmm.
And the cap.
Oh, look at Karham move, his movement. Great. 4-1. The CTF players really taking it to the TS players.
Oh, what a nice headshot.
Showing off who's boss. But yeah, up next we've got Casa, which is really a TS map, if ever there was one.
Yeah, but actually all CTF player, I think, plays in the TS clan too.
Yeah.
And everybody who play in TS clan will play one day Casa, so...
That's true.
I think they got practice at that.
No, I mean, most of the players in Urban Terror, I mean, if you look at the amount of teams in Team Survivor, it's like twice the amount of Capture the Flag teams, at least in the Urban Zone. So, yeah, you can definitely say that most Capture the Flag players are also experienced in Team Survivor. Team Survivor is a good way to hone your killing skills, where Capture the Flag is probably a good way of improving your movement and team. Oh, great job there by Samchu. Only he got he had to pay for that. He was trying to get Sutafu out full there, but unfortunately that failed, kind of.
Yeah, that was super great up there.
Oh, Karhum and Sutafu, both Dutch players. I'm not so well. As well,
I
as a
see
French
him
player.
Here. He comes back from death. Huh?
Unfortunately, I don't know all the nationalities of all players, but it's definitely a good mix. Samsung here going to make it 7-1. Oh, fantastic!
Well, maybe there will be a double cap if they will be hard.
And that team kill just in time for the respawn. Good teamwork. But that's also something that you can really see here. These most of these players have never played with each other in a team. Well, yeah, I can say most of them at least. And so there's less teamwork than you would see in regular matches. But What I want to say is that the individual skill is really showing here at the moment.
I mean, I think that's the reason why they took Jumpack and not like Abby or Algius. The team play is very improved there.
Yeah. Oh, jeez, great job, Karhum, and he's got some stamina to drop the flag over to a mate, or even going for the cap. Oh, going to pay the. Oh well, Julia there to finish it off. Great job.
Yep. And then he actually can kill the middle guy too.
I'm sure Sutafu will be a little bit angry at the moment, because if there's ever a player that doesn't like to lose, it's Sutafu. Even if it's just for fun.
Yeah, maybe with a one, but they still can win.
Well, we're going to see a... Well, we should be able to see a cap here, but Azul, well, not playing as smoothly as he should.
Oh.
Well, laser finished the cap there. A2. Well, I can't blame the GTV cameraman for not catching that. And Azul also blocking here. Well, he was instrumental in that one cap there, so no reason to. Karhum here with 1% remaining. be something special.
Well, still gets 80% nice.
Exactly, still gets 80% damage on his opponent. God damn it.
One full out.
Two full out. Nice. And Juliet did her job very well.
I mean, that is a skill of Italian national player.
Yeah.
Super nice.
And Azul, the last one standing against five of the blue guys, and he manages to stop the cap. Good job. And didn't even take some damage. A little bit of lag there, at least at my end of the screen. 2 minutes remaining, 8-2. It has to be said, blue side is the easier side on Turnpike, so maybe it's not all doom and gloom for reds, but they've got their work cut out for them. Ah, nice communication. Julia aware that two of the red guys were moving in, and there's even one more.
Wow.
Nice movement there by Samchun, finishing the destroy off. And Aiden here not getting any hits with his G36. But then again, the G36 is better on long range. Oh well, unfortunately we just switched away before he started shooting.
Actually, it was a bit of a worth attacking at the beginning and only that when defending.
Yeah. Bit of a tactical change here. Oh, nice hits for Azul. Oh, but got shot by Julia, who was, with her 17%, managed to defend.
Ah. I mean, yeah, that's the point of non-game and team playing. Because if they get team player, I think the middle guy would hold back the shoulder. Yep.
Well, will Carhum make it 9-2 in these last dying seconds of the game? Yes, he will. Very nice. Maybe a double cap here. Ah, Julia took Azul just out on time, so he's in with 100%. And Azul whining a bit about lags. Yeah, I'm sure it has nothing to do with the opponents. 3 seconds remaining. Is this enough to make a cap? No, Aiden is low on stamina and health. And 9-2, the final score of the first round. Let me just note that down.
Maybe the TS guys can now push a lot over Metro, because Metro and TS, they push a lot over Metro too, maybe.
Yeah, they exactly.
Can win the 7 points and maybe doable if they really hard person.
No, you've got a good point there, because since I think 2 years now, or maybe just only 1 year, you could really see in the Nations Cup final, the clan-based Nations Cup final, that tactics in Team Survivor have changed regarding CTF. Instead of more or less just going the usual route, so if you spawn in loading docks, you go pillars or you go middle. Now everybody starts going to Metro, which ends up in making it a very interesting match, because everybody just heads to Metro and it's very fast. It makes also for, of course, good training when you attack Metro. So maybe we'll see some of the TS guys owning at Metro.
Good dealing to be faster than in Metro, so. Maybe they will show her their movement skill now.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're hot.
Even maybe they will show their skill.
Aiden is going to camp here on top of the, I don't know what the name is of that thing. Can't be arsed to destroy. Oh, Aiden got caught out there together with his teammates. Although 2 against 2 apparently was enough.
Oh!
Good job by Azul, getting in quite a lot of damage there to Aiden, with only a couple of percent.
And he even Oh, nice try.
Will we see the first cap? No, we won't, because Reds have moved in with a lot of players, so we're in a hot potato situation. Unfortunately, Carhum was not... Samchun was not able to return that flag. Which was also the nice first cap. Warp speed. So 14 seconds till the flags explode and return to their original places. God is here really ripping into Aiden. Oh, Karhum camping up in that spot. I really like that. It shows probably how long you've been playing Urban Terror. But both clans again in... Well, not anymore. Samchun going to make this first cap? Yes, he will. No, he won't! Oh. It was returned. Oh my god. No, sorry, it wasn't returned. The other flag was returned. God damn! In one of those situations, you do want to see third-person view so that you kind of know what's happening. So 1-0 to Red. So that makes it 10-2.
That must be a cap.
Total score. Yeah, indeed.
And yes, he did it.
Oh, nice hits there for Laser. We'll be hoping for a kill, but he won't get it, I think.
Oh, nice kill by Yulia.
Got her nade ready. Yeah, good job. It was Julia was told that there were two guys camping up at pillars, and she went to middle. Unfortunately, it didn't pay off, but still, good communication. Carhum in possession of the flag. Destroy failing the
jump. Maybe they will come get it back. Oh no. And now we're
going to make a 3-1. That's always risky when you move in with the whole team. It leaves your flag open for another go.
But I think that's most of the problem from a team who started from CTF to CTF, that they push back and risk a double cap then.
Mm, yeah, but it takes some real some real coordination if you don't want all of your team to move in. I mean, most times you think, I can still save it, and most of your team also think that. Oh, Carhum here. Has to be a bit faster if he wants to stop this cap. And is he going to be on time? He is. Great return there. Julia dropping some nades at least. And, well, managed to get one kill there. But it's a hot potato situation. So both teams are in possession of each other's flags. And not anymore. Wow. Red team really doing a great job here. Aiden... returning the flag. Gets the team kill on time.
Ooh. And Thompson got a...
Oh, poor Julia. That was unexpected. Suited for camping it up. Getting
bad,
the hits. Nice. Only completely out of position now. Going to be taken out full. Or not. Wow. Or not. Wow. Great job, Sutafu. He was all alone in the red spawn with all of red spawning, and he's the only one that survived on his team.
Oh, that will be a light.
What? Nice try. Good. So it's actually 13-3 if you account for the last round as well, or the last half as well.
Yeah, but there are a bit of lag on the server, so maybe it's like excuses for all the players.
I really think that, well, I mean, it's possible, but this is not like a Turkish clan versus a European clan that you've got, that lags might be only on one side. It's just for everybody equal, more or less.
Yeah.
And it's also funny that everybody starts whining about lags when they're losing. Anyway, we've got 3 minutes remaining.
Luck.
Yeah.
All the same.
Let's throw the car in here.
But it didn't. Well.
Yeah. Sutafu was already was completely ready for him. Taker doing a good job there.
I'm actually surprised that they got 3 guys in that garden, even if they need to push in this side.
Yeah, I agree. It's a strange tactic to put most of your attacking force through. True Metro, but well, no, it's not paying off. I can't say that, unfortunately. It's always the dying seconds of the match when the whines start coming. Home now with 13%. We'll really need his help. That was close.
Yeah, the nade exploded at the perfect time. Mm.
The random nades Taker was referring to.
One pull up.
Oh, no hits. Oh, gets blocked. But still managed to make the cap. Wow, somebody was playing without a helmet there. Original.
Yeah, maybe it's because of a bit raging and... Mm. Yeah, playing without helmet is not that bad if you got under 50%.
Yeah, that's true. 40 seconds remaining. Only shows what was to be expected. Capture the flag players winning on a capture the flag map. Completely hopeless.
Oh no, the stop playing as a too.
Nice try. Ooh. Good game being called.
Yes, very nice. We saw the CTF guys dominating PS guys on CTF mode.
Yeah. So 14-3 the final score. Up next we've got Casa. And that'll take some time to load, I think. Yeah, I think it will. Let me just turn on the song and that gives both of us some time to get some drinks, I guess. Talk to you later. 1 second. 99 problems and a server is one. Well, it seems that we've switched servers, so I hope there will be less wine. So it's
and
not going.
Actually, the map.
Yeah,
too, I think.
Exactly. I was about to mention it's not a Casa at all. It's Orbital. Well, another real TS match map. Excuse me. And it seems that we've got some people still joining the server.
Well. Oh, and we got a lady in here. You love playing too.
Ooh, sexy. Anyway, waiting for. Them to ready up. The red team in this case. I wonder who the hell Ziminiaki is, but well, maybe just a he. Randomly joined the server. Oh, he disconnected. Anyway. Okay, so now everything's ready for Red to ready up.
Have fun, guys.
Well, 8-4 is not really the score. There we go, that's the right score. Following Aiden here with his preemptive nading. Oh, nice movement by Carhoom. Going to get a double kill here. Oh, well, yes, he did. It wasn't stolen.
And the TS guys are leading 1-0.
Yeah, and we've got another random joiner.
Yeah, actually, they put it the TS at the password. And the server IP on the server.
Oh, that's fantastic. Because now we've got somebody joining under an alias of mine. Or, I mean, that's not me. So, whoever that is, I would like to have your IP. Thank you very much. But you just joined an Urban Zone server. So we have it. Fucking arseholes. Seriously. No, I'm serious. I've been imitated so often now on public servers. It's getting really annoying, and people thinking that they can just my name makes them an admin.
Yeah, well, the problem is you're too famous.
Yeah,
maybe.
I'm too famous for. Well, that's why I'm going to switch my nickname, maybe.
Twelve.
Oh.
907, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Okay, well, I think it's time for the admin to time out this match and start banning people. Maybe change the password of the server, because this is just not even funny.
Or maybe just tell them, tell the guys that they put it. I think it was Easter or something. But it wasn't on purpose, just he typed it wrong on the console.
Oh yeah, I'm not saying that it's his fault, but... Anyway, let's go back to the game here. Hazel against two of the TS... of red. Nice try.
So we got spot break.
Can somebody kick that arsehole that has my nickname? Would be appreciated. I'm sure that somebody's listening to me.
Hmm. Hopefully they will stop connecting now.
Alright, 3-1 to the red team, as was to be expected on Team Survivor. We don't have separate rounds in Team Survivor. It's just 20 minutes of all-out craziness.
I'm very happy at the moment that none is camping on blue box or red room, like that. Oh, whoa, he's doing a super hit here.
Ooh, nearly a flawless.
Yes.
Three against four now. Goddess was trying to nade, but didn't expect Taker there with his LR300. Sutafu last one standing with an SR8. Well, if you want somebody to be your last man standing with an SR8, it's Sutafu or Ryuin. But still, it's a tall order. Yeah. Aiden takes him out.
What a ninja from behind. What a fast take out of the middle. He's still trying to... Oh, nice.
Nice. Well done. Expected Karhum there. Fortunately, Aiden got the better of him. He is the last one standing, and yeah, everybody of red knew where he was. Samchun getting some SR8 loving there as well. Oh, nice job there by Laser.
Yes, he's quite nice.
6-3.
Ah, seems like your faker was disconnected now.
Oh my. Well, imitating an admin, I think we can ban somebody for a season. nice try by Samchun. Unfortunately, didn't get the kill here. Destroy probably knows where he is. Oh, not getting a... Well, he got a kill eventually, but it was kind of late.
All good kills are for you.
Sutafu slowly moving in.
Oh, 2-2.
Taker probably knows that Sutafu is around about there, but... Ooh, Laser was just a little bit too fast. Samchun now all alone versus Laser and Sutafu. Maybe we'll have a little bit of an SR8 battle if... No... Oh, yes!
Whoa,
we do!
nice
quick zoom there by Sutafu. Getting... I won't say the lucky kill. It was, of course, intended.
Thank you.
red here, being surrounded by all of blue. Blue team win. Nice job.
I think the fail was that they stand on the garden and get even flanked by something from behind.
Yeah, exactly. They should have moved in if they wanted to have a bit of an advantage with, if you attack with five people at the same place. But in this case, they forgot to move in, maybe. Samtune trying to get SRH kills for the... Well, to save his life, but unfortunately... everything starts to miss. Maybe it's time to switch and SR8 for an automatic. Sorry, it's been a long day. Working since 8 a.m. Have to work again tomorrow at 8 a.m.
What a bitch. Actually, I think it was even a good choice to pick Orbital for the map, because it's more faster than Kaza, and I think the CTF guys got really a chance here to win.
That's true.
But it's really a little bit late.
To be honest, I also think that nice predictive gaming there by Sutafu. Orbital is a lot more entertaining than Kaza, so I'm glad that they. Oh, wow, fantastic hits there for Aiden, taking two out in a row and making it 9-5. Sutafu trying to medic, but not successfully, actually. Doing it, but Laser has 80% again. Good communication from the CTF guys. Yuna, last one standing. Sneaky, sneaky. Nice try. Unfortunately, there were three of the blues surrounding her. So we've passed the halfway. Oh, sorry. Shouldn't have switched that off for the viewers. We've passed the halfway point of the match now, or of the TS part of this match.
I was taking a shot on now. Two wills, three. Sutafu alone, one person.
Is he going to Red Room? Yeah, that's where I would go if I was him. Only problem with that ladder is it makes noise.
If you make the three kills, I will give them a beer.
You'll personally send him a beer? Poor Sutafu, completely surrounded. Great job, though, by Carhum and Samchin, making sure of the kill and the round, of course. 9-7, not all has been played yet. I mean, the CTF guys can still win this.
I was something like 7-3, I know this. 9-7 is really a 1 for the CTF guys.
Poor Taker. His score is definitely not that as good. 5 against 15. Well, I guess that's what happens if you play against the best of the best and have an off day, maybe. Good movement by Azul. Unfortunately, he had two guys surrounding around his area. 10-7.
Still will able. Maybe take a pull on his super hips then.
Yeah.
They still can win. Taker with four guys.
Good luck with that. Yeah. Nice try.
Nice try. Yeah, even if he hit it later with one shot, and if it could be, then he would be really sick there.
Yeah. Azul doesn't know how to play TS. Actually, I would be completely lost. I mean, I know how to play TS. I mean, I know how to shoot somebody, but that's pretty much all I know. I wouldn't know what the tactics are.
I actually don't know what is what, because many people say to Moonview, Blue Box, or to Globe Command, and all this stuff.
Oh, great job there by Sutafu. And Yuna now going to make another kill. Yes. We might have the first flawless. Now got take dies there.
Ah, at the beginning there was a flawless, I think, from blue team, but...
Oh, really? Okay. Well, then I missed that. Let's follow Sutafu once more. See if he can get one of those magical S8 kills. Ooh, nice team kill. Sutafu knows that they are in red room.
Oh,
nice shot. Got the hit on the arms, unfortunately. And Karim was around the corner. So, Laser versus Karhum here. Oh, great. Nice try by Karhum with the SR8. And now just making use of the speed that Urban Terror gives you. Can pick it up a bit. You were talking about blue box camping. Well, here we go. This is more like try and catch each other. Ooh, headshot.
The loser comes.
I didn't even hear him.
Yeah, that's the sneaky laser for
that. Yeah, exactly.
Well known in the German community.
Oh yeah, like sneaking is exclusively German.
For sure.
If you want a translation of that Dutch, I think I'll just spare that from for you. God is finishing it off, making it 15-7. 8 the difference, 2 and a bit minutes remaining. This is going to be hard for or impossible more or less for the CTF guys to win.
Yeah. And now the excuses start for who what.
Nah, I don't think there's any excuses here for the CTF guys. I mean, they know that they were, I mean, it's the same as to be expected. Oh, nice job there by Yuna getting in some damage and moving into medic.
Oh, dead was on it, I think.
Oh, I love to see that. Just not reckless and go for the two Desert Eagle shots. Now one by one, finishing it off. And Karhum now with, well, 10 and a bit percent remaining, and Yuna finishing it off. Great. Just loved watching Yuna play that round there. If it wasn't 3 kills, then they sure were a show off of how to play TS.
It's something like slowlier than CTF. I mean, it's not Oh lol, not a thought.
UNS has really been rampant this last minute. But
oh,
she
lord.
Finally got killed by Samtune.
Red team wins.
So both All-Stars winning their respective game modes. I'm not sure if there will be a third map. I don't think so. I don't hope so, since I have to work tomorrow. This is probably going to be the last Shoutcast for some time. At least in the Winter Cup, we don't really see a reason to Shoutcast.
Oh, one more round, man.
Yeah, one more round. Oh, nice. But don't forget, you can still sign up and join 116 other clans for the Winter Cup. Some clans have already been playing like 25 matches or 20.
Ooh, nice.
It's really sick. 20 matches in 4 days.
Yeah. Everybody's
Oh, fantastic. Whoa. Oh my god, Juna, what a player, seriously. Hats off to Juna there for...
I think that's the skill of a girl.
Player of the match, at least of the TS match part. Great job. I hope you've all enjoyed this Shoutcast. It's, as I said, it's going to be the last one for at least a month. When the normal seasons will start again, then... we'll be back as usual. Thanks a lot to Riches for shoutcasting with me. I think you passed with flying colors. Great job. And I'm sorry, Xandax. I just saw your message here now that you wanted to shoutcast with me. I'm sorry. Better luck next time. I hope you've all enjoyed it. We'll keep an eye out on the YouTube channel this weekend, because I'll be uploading the matches there when I've got some time in the weekend. And I might also finally get around to uploading 30 or so new maps to the Urban Zone download area. Thanks for watching for the fifth time, probably, and we'll see you around.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.